Director Faden. real action.
Blockages and pipes see through. When the converters and coolant pumps are working again, we should be able to get this baby back down to a safe temperature. I hope.
What do you know about the hiss?
Not much, only what I've seen. Well, they use the same tactics that Marshall and Salvador taught us, which makes me think that the hiss haven't completely erased the people inside, which is a pretty fucking horrible thought. Or they're just using whatever they find in their victims' heads. In any case, they are really eager to get inside the power plant.
Why do you think that is?
Shit, I don't know. They want to make my life harder?
What do you do here, Arish?
Security chief of the maintenance sector. I make sure all the weird shit down here doesn't bother the maintenance crews. Learned everything I know from Salvador. The best security agent this bureau has ever seen.
And you like your job?
I love it. You know, everyone thinks that maintenance is the lowest rung on the ladder just because we fix pipes instead of writing memos, but I gotta be honest. These are the bravest people in the goddamn building. I'm proud to work with them.
I've done a few odd jobs with these kind of folks. They say what they mean. I like that.
What exactly is the power plant?
Listen, I only know what Salvador told me, but I know it generates all the electricity for the Bureau, and it's got two very simple rules. Rule one, keep it below a certain temperature. Rule two, don't ever, ever open it. Oh, I shouldn't ask.
Sounds like secrets are standard operating procedure around here.
Oh, yeah, it's all part of the job.
What do you know about the service weapon?
Not much. That thing is director only. Salvador told me by the time he saw Trench use it. Sounds like that gun can do some serious damage. Yeah, I did see pictures of it once, though, and it looks different to that thing you're carrying. You monitor something? It's new.
Is new a good thing?
Given the circumstances, I'd say new is our best bet.
Do you know this Ati guy?
Of course. He's my favorite coffee break buddy. Dude has got some crazy stories. He probably knows more than anyone else around here, if you can make sense of what he's saying.
Any idea where he's from?
I'm guessing Sweden.
He's from where he's from. Look, there are just some stones that are better left unturned, you know?
I should be going. Try to stay alive.
You got a lockdown to lift.
Thank you. station for some real action.
My name is Dr. Pierce, lead researcher of the parakinesiology.
Like that sound.
Come on.
My old enemy, the clock, is blocking the pipes. You need to deal with that shit. He is very clever. He's trying to sneak in. We got him caught with his hand in the fist.
together a little longer.
Thank you. so fast, I'm...
Crew feels a lot safer when you're around.
I should be going. Try to stay alive.
You gotta lock down the lift.
To fix this thing ASAP.
Thank you.
protect them. Forces contain the lockdown.
That's it. The other sector should be open now. I think it's time I told Emily why I'm here. I'll risk it. You two should get to know each other.
They say the new director can launch objects up to 20 feet.
Bullshit. We've never recorded any distance over 5.
Obviously, you have 60.
Jesse, you made it. And you lifted the internal lockdown.
Let's talk. Listen, Emily. Screw it. Just tell her. I haven't been completely honest. I have a younger brother. Dylan. When we were kids, we found an old slide projector in Ordinary's landfill. The slides created doorways to other places. Bad things happened. Came through.
That's all she gets. The rest stays locked inside.
But we found help. Through one of the doorways, we met something. A being.
A being? What kind of being?
It's hard to describe, but it... She helped us. We managed to turn the projector off. The bad things that came through the doorways were gone. After that, your people came. Tried to grab us. I ran away. They got Dylan.
I left him behind.
Bureau agents took your brother?
Yes. He covered it up. No one believed me. I just want to find Dylan. I've been looking for him ever since.
What happened to the slide projector? It sounds like another object of power.
I thought you took it. The Bureau. Along with Dylan.
I've never heard of it. But around here, I assume everything's classified. You know, I looked into the ordinary AWE case files after you mentioned it. Trench and Darling were both involved. A large area of the containment sector was reserved for it. The case hasn't been active for a long time. I have no idea if anything's still there. Can you tell me more about this being you found?
Let's hope you two get along.
She's been with me ever since Ordinary. In my head. She led me to you. I call her Polaris.
As in a guiding star. Did Polaris know about the hiss? If she got you in here in spite of the lockdown, she's very powerful. Which may help explain your test results. Your readings are incredible, Jesse. Now, cross-referencing them with the database, I found two matches in Darling's old classified files. Unfortunately, I can't access them beyond the file codes, but one was P6, referring to a prime candidate for a potential future bureau director. This was logged years ago.
Dylan. Is that Dylan?
The other match is on something called Hedron, which must be connected to these Hedron Resonance amplifiers somehow. All I know is that Marshall went to the research sector to secure the HRA production after the Hiss first attacked.
So, Marshall seems like our best lead on Dylan.
I need to go after her. How can I get to the research sector?
Use my key card. The sector elevator will take you there.
Marshall is the next step. What Emily told me about Ordinary, my powers being connected to things in the Bureau's past. I am so close to something. Do you feel it? Something's coming.
We take turns to come for a visit. I helped you. You owe me now. And when time comes, I will come calling.
Hi, Jesse.
I keep finding traces of Darling, but still can't find him. Where could he be?
He's usually in his office in research or one of his labs. Dr. Darling has quite a few all around the Bureau. Could be hiding in any one of them. I'd check myself, but I don't have access to most of them.
Sounds like I touched a nerve.
He didn't let you into his labs?
Not all of them, no. Some had volatile material. That's ridiculous. I mean, this whole place is volatile material. Could have at least thought of a more convincing lie. I mean, how can I work without access to all the data possible?
This place has a bad habit of moving around, huh?
So you notice the building shifts. Did you know that 39% of bureau accidents are caused by the shifts? It's true. I ran the numbers myself.
So they're dangerous.
Oh, very. Yet one time, a shark got shifted into a meeting room along with over 2,000 gallons of water. It was a tiger shark. Darling's pet research project. I forget what he was researching.
How do people work here?
You said you're an assistant?
Oh, it's just a title. I'm a scientist, a researcher. I work for Dr. Darling. See, when Bureau agents go out in the field, the sites of altered world events, we study the materials, the altered items they bring back. It's always something we've never seen before, and studying them requires new instruments, methodologies, sometimes entirely new fields of science.
Emily really loves her job.
See, there's no guidebook for what we do here. Everything that happens at the Bureau, including the science, is without precedent.
What exactly is the Ocean View Motel?
That's a bigger question than you might think. You see, I have extreme doubts that the motel is a single place. I mean, look at all the doors inside it. Where do they all go? We know that one door leads to the oldest house, but how come we can only ever open that one door? Maybe to open a door, you have to have entered through it. So if every door leads to a different dimension, plane, reality, whatever you want to call it, then I believe that the motel is firm proof that parallel universes exist.
Does Darling agree with that?
I haven't told him yet. I'm waiting until I can prove it.
What can you tell me about control points?
They're nexus points of the oldest house's unique energies. Now, I wrote a 30-page proposal hypothesizing that we could siphon energy directly from them. Darling didn't even get through the first page before he turned it down.
Right. And, has anyone ever used them to teleport around?
What, no. What, I mean, you mean physically? No, not that I've ever heard of.
Why? Because that's how they work for me.
What? Really? Oh my god. More tests.
Let's hold off on the tests until later, okay?
Okay. It's just... wow. This blows my control point theories right out of the water. I love it.
See you soon.
Be careful out there.
Darling arguing a couple weeks ago. Trench was furious. You don't think... Darling... Darling.
Don't be stupid. What would the Bureau's golden child have to gain from killing the boss?
executive sector is supposed to have a designated security team here for our protection. Where the hell are they?
If the internal lockdown is in effect, then they can't use the elevator branches. We're on our own.
Booker, to Smith, the others? Why did they start acting like that?
Barrett like got him, but honestly, I don't know
what
happened. A lot of these questions could be answered by obtaining live specimen.
Here? But we don't have the proper facilities.
Maybe we can bring an observation from the containment sector.
packages in Type C through...
I've been getting reports that something's tearing up the training grounds. Might be worth checking out.
I should be going.
Right. You got a lockdown to lift.
Wide and capable of storing a whopping 80 kilobytes.
Thank you.
has asked us to talk to him.
She's in trouble. I need to reach her.